Beyond the farm fields, we often forget about soil health right under our feet in cities and urban areas. Nowhere is this more apparent than the Big Apple, where I learned how New York City Parks and Recreation teams ensure their soils can sustain growth in the concrete jungle.
There's a lot of research out there about soil health and a ton of technical information, but none of it does us any good unless we can see how it actually takes place at the ground level. My name is Tim Hamrich from the Future of Agriculture podcast. Cool Planet and I are gonna travel the country and capture stories about how land stewards and growers and farmers are actually developing their own soil health and how that impacts their lives and the food they're growing for you.
This week's episode takes us to New York City, where I met up with Nave Strauss, Director of Street Tree Planting for NYC Parks.
Fill us in, like help people understand and appreciate the work that you do here.
So what my role is basically to make sure that trees are being planted in the right place, the right species are chosen. We're working to restore and introduce, really, more canopy into various neighborhoods throughout the city. So one of our metrics is also making sure that trees are planted well, in addition to there being lots of them,
right,
that we respond to citizen requests fairly quickly, and that we're planting trees in areas that are particularly vulnerable to a particular health-related issue.
Over your time with New York City Parks, what have you learned about the soils here in this area?
It's easy to assume that soils in New York are not healthy, right, because we're in this big urban environment. But nature sort of suggests otherwise, right? We have lots of healthy tracts of natural forest throughout our parklands, and we have lots of trees that seem to be growing and thriving in the soil that's within our landscaped areas of parks, and we have trees that are growing really well along our public rights-of-way, along our streets. The old practice was always plant a tree and replace all the soil. And the way that we're trying to go in an effort to also reduce costs, but potentially dispose of less good quality or usable material, given how resilient trees are, is to look at soil, especially the soil that happens to be on site, which for our intents and purposes, I'm gonna call native soils, right? On-site soils are native soils. And we're gonna try to reuse them. And to that end, that's what we're really trying to learn about, is how do soils vary from, you know, the top of the Bronx, which is replete with tons of granite and, you know, higher clay content, all the way down to the South Shore of Long Island, which is really sandy, right? And then all the way down to Staten Island, which actually happens to mimic more of like closer to what like the South would be with a heavier clay loam. So we really believe that there's a lot of potential to be using not only the right species, which is something we've always done, but the right soils in the right place too.
What other aspects of soil health or practices are you trying to use to try to build kind of soil health over time?
In addition to using what's already there, and even in instances where we're going to replace soil altogether, what we're going to do is try to start with a good soil if we're replacing soil, right? So a good pH and a good texture and decent electrical low electrical conductivity, because we don't want to have too many soil salts present, because that can damage roots. And then we're gonna just, again, in an effort to try to mimic those forest conditions, we're gonna start using sort of a ribbon of compost and biochar, in all likelihood, to start to promote that benefit. So as those materials begin to leach down into the soil, again, mimicking forest conditions, we're hopefully beginning to replenish the soil or just, you know, continue to add to its microbiome.
New York City, you've got a lot of different perspectives, and I'm sure you have people that question how much should the city be spending on trees and on parks. What do you tell those people about the importance of what your department does?
In a big city, people believe that you know, there are other priorities. And you know, I think that we would all tend to agree that everybody needs what everybody needs, all those public resources. However, trees are part of public health. So we try to approach it from a public health aspect, you know, and try to give that perspective. We try to also remind people that it's on public property, and this one tree might not really fit your ideal, but really this one tree is part of a larger forest. And even more so than just the New York City forest, is actually a part of a continuation of our northeastern forests, right? And really, in the big picture, our tree planting budget is a drop in the bucket. And it's just such an incredible investment, because ideally, so long as we've done our work correctly, this tree will outlive all of us. And its benefits are not just for me and you, and they're not even just for our kids, they might be for our kids' kids. And that's an amazing thing. And that actually is what brings me to work every single day, knowing that my daughter and her daughter and her friends will all get to benefit from the work that me and my staff do.